to examine and study these four traditions and impact of Vedic culture, philosophy and values on them. The Vedas written by Aryans, and in our Indian history, ancient Indian period, there are two types of conflict between the Aryan and non-Aryan. Aryan may called the writer of Vedas, and non-Aryan may called the out of Varna system. The Aryan. My paper will raise the question, who is the Aryan? The Aryan inverts entered the Indian subcontinent. The natives who were captured in the raids were later termed as the slaves, whereas those who managed to flee the people into the forests were termed as the Shudras. The Aryan sought to legitimize their exploits by establishing the Varna system and branded the captured natives as Shudras. They also created the caste system to oppress the society. It is an accepted fact that Aryans wrote the Vedas, that I have mentioned also. It is also widely believed that Aryan had come to India from Asia Minor. Those with imperialist predilection among them vanquished the original inhabitants in the battles and established their empire. On the other hand, the rishis and thinkers among them founded a religion, developed a script, and crafted a philosophy, etc. among the masses. That brought into the existence a mixed culture which continued elements of the both Aryan as well as the local culture. Original of Vedas. My second point of research is that who is the origin of Vedas? When we talk the Vedic culture, Rigveda is the oldest and primary sources of our knowledge about it. The Rigveda was written 100 years before Christ. The rest of Vedic literature comprising the Samveda, Atharveda and Ayurveda were written much later. These texts are the basis of recreation of the lifestyle, religious, philosophy and institutions of the Aryans by the historian. Then what is the caste system of India? Is it the Varna system developed or otherwise it is the different way of caste system? I clarify next slide. The caste system, whether the Varna system was based on the own birth or once conducted is anybody's guess. I have raised the question that the caste system is the origin of Varna system, and if it is based on birth, then how can we define the Varna system? And if it based on the work, then how can be a stability between the Varnas, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaisyas and Shudras? In India, the religion and religious texts have always resigned the supreme all over other philosophies, knowledge and laws. This is a true of ancient India as the contemporary one. The religions and religious treaties have not only influenced Indian society and culture, but have also virtually led them. They have been main driving forces of Indian society. The values of these religions help make the society more human. But here it must be remembered that this was the true only of the initial stages of the evaluation of different religion. As this religion got institutionalized, their flexibility and their human values inherent in them began to dissipate. So, democratic structure was aged out of the totalitarian tendencies, the objective of the religion. The question again raised that what is the objective of religious text or the Vedas founder? Initially, the objective of the religion was to make man more moral, compassionate and accountable to the family and society, and to help him shed his innate anarchic tendency. But once religion got institutionalized and linked to religious texts, in a sense, it insulted the human and society. People were corrupted into the adhering to the institutionalized norm of religious and religion text by tyrannizing them and pressurizing them through the ruler. That is why it can be safely concluded that the power of religion and religious edicts has always been supreme in India. Then this is the Varna system. Upper caste called Brahmin, Kshatriyas, second one, and third one, Vaishyas, and last of Varna system is the part of Shudras. Varna based vision of the society, talking of Hindu religion and Brahminical Hinduism, from its very beginning, it discriminated between the people on the basis of their caste and Varna. The Varna-based vision of the society was censored by the Hindu religious text. These texts say that Brahmin born from the mouth of Brahma, Akshatriya from his hand, Vaishya from his thighs, and Shudras from his feet. This unscientific and illogical interpretation analysis, which files in the face of basic patterns of the sociology, is based on Hindu religious text. Here, it is important to note that a sizable number of untouchability and Chandans also lived in the country, but they are given no place in the Varna-based system. Or we can say Chandans and the untouchable caste is called Panch Jan. Similarly, women are referred to with respect in Hindu religions are rarely referred. Brahmins were the regulators of Hinduism as well as the writers of its religious texts like Vedas, who written the Vedas, and this is the regulator of Hinduism. A strong faith and respect regarding these texts, but despite being ignorant about their context, because all the Vedas are written in Sanskrit, and this is the difficult language of understand by the masses. But after that, ignorant all the texts, they practice in their life. This is respect and faith never adapted. The reason was to claim that these texts are the apocrypha, not written by any. Once this formulation was accepted, discussing these texts or rising the question on them become tantamount of blasphemy. That is why the division of the society into the various Varna and caste were never questioned, neither by the Shudras nor by the upper caste of the people. Of course, once in a while, in some historian and ideological phases, logic scholars, thinkers like Kosambi, Kastuba, Gautama Buddha, Charvak, and in the Middle Ages, Kabir, Ravidas, Dadutyal, Vaisheshwar, etc., did raise their question, but their views are higher ignored, or the followers were tortured and their throats prodded. In initial structure of the Varna system was crafted, keeping the interest of the society in mind. Of course, I also believe in that. But with the passage of time, it got distorted, and all four the Varna shed their flexibility and become tradition bound. The Shudras was most impacted by this change. In the post-Vedic era, Shudras were only hated, but by the era of Samritis, they became treated as a curse and scourge. For example, we have a state in MP and in Haryana. One guy belonged to Dalits or lower Varna. He buried the thresher machine because he is bagging their workout rupees. The insular structure, I have clarified that in the most Vedic era, but treated as a curse of sources. By these texts, the sources were meant to serve the Brahman. Shudras were meant to serve the Brahman. Brahman declared that all this system is run by or practiced by according to a Hindu religious text. And in this religious text, the Shudras were meant by serving only. Brahman declared that the main duty of the Shudras was to serve the Brahman, Akshatriyas, Vaishyas with sincerity and pure mind. But there have a law. For their purification, the Shudras should perform the Archaman. Once after defecting the consciousness, Shudras should get their head tonsured once every month. It is duty of Shudras that for their bone welfare, they should serve such renowned householder Brahmin who are the scholars of Vedas. If he is unable to earn their life, then he is serving the Brahmin, and if he should not serve, if he didn't find the life, then he served the Akshatriyas. If even this, his needs are not fulfillment, then he should serve rich Vaishyas. Because the Vaishyas is similar like Shudras, but their standard is more good other than Shudras. Even if a Shudra is capable of amassing wealth, he should not do so, because he become the wealthy, intoxicated with wealth, he will insult the Brahmin. Altarian paradigm followed. Most of the scholars of Indian history, influenced by the Altarian paradigm, believe that women enjoyed more rights and liberty in the Rigvedic era, that their condition deteriorated as centuries rolled by. Altaker believed that in the barbaric primitive communities, there was no curb on the atrocities of man on women, and that women were given less to eat and lot of work was extracted from them. Two-side exploitation of Dalit women. It is the sizable performance by upper caste women, and now I am discussing the exploitation of women, double or triple or fourth exploitation. I have given the sources of only Sanskrit texts, that's why I discuss only two sides of exploitation by the Dalit women. Therefore, I expressed great satisfaction over the fact that status of women in Vedic era was better than what one should have generally expected. Of course, our source contain enough evidence to prove that in stipulating the penalty of morganatic marriage and sex relation crimes, dominical, theoretical, bluntly favored men of upper caste, and that women were subjected to a double value. They were exploited both because of their gender and their status in the society. The religion, canon and smritis prescribe the strength provision of the Shudras. Okay, I have already discussed with you, I have bound my paper in Vedic literature only, and I have already discussed that pre-Vedic or initial period, the status of Shudras is not good, but so-so. But after coming, after passing the time of canon or Manu Samriddhi, then it is more crucial. That is why I discuss the, Samriddhis also, exploiting of the Dalit woman. If one is seeing a Shudra woman, and Shudra woman is seeing one, then one should not study Veda, etc. Similarly, a student should not study when he is seeing a woman who has sexual relationship with a man of lower birth. Food bought by a dasi is not eatable. If a Brahmin man serves a Shudra woman of dark complexion for one day or one night, then he can atone for his sin by taking bath after every month meal of 3 years. But according to the commentator, I take the source of Yajnavalkya Smriti, the writer of Yajnavalkya Rishi, and their commentator, commentator is called Mitakshra, and that is the Mitakshra commented. If a Brahmin has sexual intercourse with a Shudra woman for one night, he can atone for his sin through the same means. If a menstruation woman, Brahmin woman, touches a menstruation Shudra woman, then she can purify herself by day-night fast and panchagami. If in Agni Mantra, wife of Shudra Varna, those who have been disloyal, those who have lies, those who do not observe the fast, and women who have had sexual intercourse out of the marriage should not be appointed. A Brahmin son born of Shudra woman and who has given the sankra by a Brahmin is cultured slave, otherwise he is an uncultured slave. The son of a Kshatriya born of Shudra woman is Gopal, and his food can be eaten by the Brahmin. There is no doubt about it. While marrying the daughter of Shudra, one should hold only end of a clause, but the Brahmin should not perform any religious ceremony with his Shudra's wife. This means that Brahmin Varna system belong to Varna system, upper caste, have four wives. One Brahmin caste, second one Akshatriyas, third one Vaishyas, and fourth one Shudra. They have the right of marriage, four Varna, between four Varna. While marrying the daughter of Shudra, one should hold only the end of her clause, but the Brahmin must not perform any religious ceremony with his Shudra's wife. That is the law of for a Shudra woman. The Shudra wife of Brahmin should have no association with the religion. Therefore, the marriage of a Shudra with a woman of higher Varna has been described as iniquitous, and sunborn of such a union is also not legitimate. Dvij by marrying, Dvij mean the people who write the write and reading the Vedas or books or literature. But that is called the Upanayan Sanskar. Upanayan Sanskar, after the Upanayan Sanskar, they called Dvij. There is a provision, this provision is only Brahman, not other than Varna system, or maybe Kshatriyas also, but there is no find evidence in Sanskrit text. I based my topic on Sanskrit text also. Therefore, the marriage of Shudra was a woman of higher Varna has been described as iniquitous, and son of born of such a union is also legitimized, which by marrying Varna system woman due to infatuation turned their entire family, including son, into the Shudras. If anybody from Brahmin caste marry the Shudra woman, all the members of the family became the Shudra. Then how the division of the assets of Shudra woman or Shudra. The religious texts also have a provision regarding the division of the assets of the Brahmin who have wives of all the Varna system. After keeping Dharbhanga, aside three parts would go to the son of Brahmin wife, two parts of Akshatriya's wife, one and half to Vaishya's, and one part to Shudra's man. If Shudra woman and Brahmin got married, this is the lower and upper. Lower Shudra woman and upper Brahmin. That is why they give the part of assets, one part of assets. Or if it belong to Shudra man and Brahmin woman, then there is no provision to keep the assets anybody. If a man of three higher Varna has sexual intercourse with a Shudra woman, he should be banished from the country. If a menstruation woman is struck by a man, a Brahmin woman can become pure by performing the kritch, that is called kritch. If a Shudra woman's son is obedient like a despile, then he can subsume on the wealth of his Brahmin father, who does not have any other son. My paper conclusion is that in all these provisions, not only a Shudra woman has been branded as impure, but by prescribing marriage of a woman of a lower Varna with a man of higher Varna, the caste system is sure to be standard and institutionalized. Thus, a Shudra woman not only pollutes the Varna-based superiority, but she is subordinate to Shudra man too. Thus, subjecting her to dual subordinate. Dr. Sunira Jaiswal, a writer of caste, religious, jati, varna, udbhav, or caste, that is the book's name, she is the writer of that book. Dr. Sunira Jaiswal comment regarding the system of purity and impurity which create an institutionalized hierarchical structure within the Varna system are eminently quotable. The Brahmin were the focal point of this system. The key issue is not that concept regarding the marriage or food, acceptability of food, etc. were based on the caste. But the key issue is that these concepts were made a part of the social psyche in such a way that social inequity became institutionalized and crude caste-based exploitation was given religion sanction. The Vedic theological norm continued to present in various forms in modern India, due to which the society had been divided horizontally and vertically on the basis of the concept of high and low. The study of philosophy and values useful for humanity of Vedic and Upanishad period has been confined to academic circle and is not being used for the welfare of the society. The Varna-based vision of the society and use of the religion in the politics to build fascist consciousness have forced the marginalized social group as well as those in the mainstream into a struggle for existence. This is coming in the way of building of a healthy democratic society. Thanks.
Close kar do usko.
Stature versus agency claimed in the US cultural study literature. Should I just close it? So the title